As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my...
Welcome everyone to this week's episode of Unrooted, Menlo College Wrestling Edition. And my guest for this week's show was none other than Iman Kazem of the women's wrestling team. Iman, thanks so much for joining me on the show.
Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome. Let's start by getting to know you a little bit better. You've already enjoyed a lot of success here at Menlo College. Do you have a favorite moment from your time as a collegiate wrestler?
You know, I have so many favorite moments. I think one that I really liked was last year at Nationals. We had one of our former teammates, Katie Chesson, in the finals, and she was the only one from our team in the finals. So earlier that day, we had gone to Burger King, and we all grabbed the Burger King crowns.
The crowns,
and we
yes.
flipped them inside out. And so it's, you know, there was no logo, and we all wrote "Go Katie" on the crown. So we all wore them during her finals match. We looked so crazy, but it was so much fun.
That is pretty special. I actually, I think that's a really unique, awesome way to kind of get everybody on the team together and show your support in a weird, goofy Menlo College way.
Yeah, I swear Katie started laughing during her match.
Oh, she probably did too. As soon as she saw those, you know that she was dying inside. I want to go back to 2016 when you became an All-American for the first time. What was that experience like for you being a young collegiate wrestler and having to battle all the way back from the consolation bracket very early on?
You know, It was really nerve-wracking because I knew that if I lost any of those matches, I would be out. Those are called the blood rounds, really. Those are the matches that get you to the semis. And once I won and realized I was in the semis, I knew I had placed as an All-American, and I was so hyped up, you know? So then after that, it was just like, all right, you're in there. Now we have to get up there. So I did take fifth. Wasn't the best that I could have hoped for, but I was really happy to be a placer.
How did that experience prepare you for coming back a second time last year? I'm sure that was just tons easier.
I just knew to try not to lose, and I had one loss that set me back a bit. I came back and placed again, only one spot higher, but I made it to, instead of wrestling for fifth, I wrestled for third. So it was a cooler experience. You know, I was a little bit farther in my goal.
For sure. Now, last season, you also earned WCWA Academic All-American honors on top of your two-time All-American status on the mats. I know your professors obviously want to hear this, but how do you strike such a balance between being strong in the classroom and strong on the mats as well?
You know, it's hard. We often find ourselves doing homework on flights, doing homework, in airports, just all kinds of times. And honestly, sometimes even the class before it's due because we just don't have time. That's the that's the truth of it. It's really nice that we have so many athletes at Menlo, and the teachers are willing to accommodate us.
For sure.
Other than that, sometimes I just wake up early, like 7 a.m. I'll wake up and just do homework till my 10 o'clock class. It's pretty hard to keep up sometimes.
I say this every time I ask it, but you student athletes are crazy. I don't know how you do it.
You know, we just do.
Yeah, you don't have a choice, really.
We don't.
You
yeah.
put yourself into this position.
We did.
All right, let's talk a little bit about the team now. Last week, Joey Martinez was my guest on the show, and he was talking a little bit about the Missouri Valley Open, where you ladies competed, saying it was going to be some of the best competition you'd face all year long, and Menlo finished second place out of 45 teams. Tell me a little bit about the tournament. How tough was it?
You know, this tournament has every team there except for the first ranked, which is Simon Fraser there in Canada, and some of the West Coast teams. I mean, mostly all of them. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of a mini nationals, we call it. It was really awesome. We just really realized that we are up in the rankings. We didn't even know we placed second until the tournament was over. We didn't know we were even top five. And it was really awesome experience. Everywhere you looked, you saw a Menlo girl. Like, the problem was that we didn't have enough coaches for how many girls are wrestling. I mean, I guess that's a good problem to have. It was really cool seeing we had 11 out of 15 placers. That's the best we've done at, pretty much a collegiate tournament in general. Pretty awesome.
And it's being reflected right now in the national standings. The Oaks are ranked 7th in the nation, and based off the tournament in Missouri, you're performing like it. How do you ladies push each other every single week to get better as a team?
You know, we're ranked 7th, even though we placed 5th last year. I don't know how that happened. Our team isn't too happy, but that motivates us. You know, we started off ranked 10th this season. We just know each other's capabilities, and if we don't see each other living up to it, then we push each other harder, you know. We call each other out, and it helps keep us on track and push ourselves harder.
Going back to you talking about 11 individuals placing, it really echoes the depth of this women's team. It's something that I'm always impressed with every time I see you ladies compete. How well do you think that you match up with some of the other powerhouses like Simon Frazier in the nation? I know you just said you feel like you were gypped a little bit being ranked so low. So how do you feel like you can stack up?
As a team?
Yes.
I feel that before, if we had a dual meet or a dual tournament against other schools, we would have, you know, half the matches in the bag and the other half would kind of be toss-ups. Mm-hmm. Now I feel we could run through almost any team. It's just that we've built this team chemistry that every other team sees and we can feel it. Other teams come up to us saying that they wish they were on our team. And mm-hmm. we're just like, sorry, full capacity, you know? So yeah, I mean, I really feel we can compete with almost any team, even Simon Frazier, as mm-hmm. as intimidating as they might be to some, we're not really scared. We're just ready to go and, you know, kick butt.
Of course, yeah, and it's a good attitude to have. Now, Menlo doesn't host many wrestling events over the course of the year, but the Blue and White Duel is coming up on December 8th. That is the following weekend. Even though it's an inner squad, what's it like to be wrestling in front of the home crowd?
You know, I don't care if half the bleachers are filled. The fact that we have our own home squad watching just us, not any of the other schools, mm-hmm. is such an awesome experience. It's really fun to call friends and family to come out to, even if you have one or two people supporting you. Just the environment of being at home is really nice, as opposed to flying every time we compete.
For sure. I can imagine that would be a little bit of a grind later on in the season when you're having to go back and forth and log so many miles.
Yeah.
What's that like? I'm sure that just puts an even bigger strain on top of the classwork, the practice, all that kind of stuff you have to throw together.
You know, we can think about how hard it is. Then I just think about the other teams that drive 16 hours to get to a tournament because, yeah. you know, they're a state away or two states mm-hmm. away. I just think about it makes us stronger. We sometimes get off the plane and compete the same day, and yeah. the jet lag is killer. But we get used to it, and it's just... It's we're probably one of the only teams other than Simon Frazier that flies places. So mm-hmm. And you know, some West Coast schools, but it's really fun. It's a fun experience getting on the plane as a team, and just something to make the college athletic experience even more real.
For sure. And we're not going to hit too much on the men's team in this interview, but I do want to ask one question. What's the bond and the relationship like between the men's wrestling program here and the women's wrestling program? Two very successful nationally ranked programs.
It's much better than it was before. I feel that our bond now just gets stronger as every year goes by. They see us working hard, and I feel the respect that they have for us has grown more. We can feel it, and we see them working hard when we walk through the room. We just see them grinding it out. So both of us have a lot of respect for each other's teams, and it has brought our program together as a whole more. And, you know, you see us sitting together, talking all the time. We always have classes together. Mm-hmm. It's a really nice unit to have.
Awesome. All right, Iman, let's get into the final segment of the show. It's called Brownie Bites. I'm going to ask you three random off-the-wall questions. You give me your best answer.
All right, let's do it.
Question number one, which teammate of yours is the most avid napper?
All right, so my teammates, Nessa and Christy, would probably have to have a nap off. Because they both are probably the best snappers I've ever seen. They probably nap more than I can sleep in a night. So we should definitely have them do that, see who the winner is.
Okay, so is the winner going to be who naps the longest or the most amount of times during a day?
You know, I don't know. Sometimes they say they're going to take a nap and it ends up being a whole nother night of sleep.
See, because that's the debate. What really is a nap? Are we going to talk maybe like a 90-minute sleep? Or are we going to talk 4 or 5 hours where it does become a night of sleep? Well, what's the cutoff here?
I don't even know their preference. I think sleeping in general is a hobby for them.
I should have just asked who's the most avid sleeper.
Sleeper.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Question number two. If you could pick any wrestler to be your own personal bodyguard, not that you need one or anything, who are you going to pick and why?
Given I'm one of the bigger girls on the team, you know, I would choose, surprisingly, Autumn. Pacheco.
Really?
She's small, but she's very observant, and I feel that she would keep me out of bad situations by looking around and gauging the environment, and I probably wouldn't have to, you know, run into anybody scary or anything like that.
Kind of like the eyes in the back of the head kind of thing, where she knows her surroundings very well.
Yeah, she. I feel like she could be feisty if she needed to be.
All right. And then question number three, which wrestler, men's or women's, would have the best time at a Selena Gomez concert?
Men's or women's? Let's see. You know, I would want to say Solon, but I don't think she's a Selena Gomez fan. She loves singing. She'd probably sing her heart out. But I would probably say Peter Wu.
Really?
I feel like he would have a good time anywhere. I could just I could picture him being, I love you, Selena.
I'm not really a fan of you, but I love you anyways.
I feel like he'd have a good time. I don't know.
All right. Well, good answer. Iman, thank you for joining me on the show.
I appreciate it.
You're welcome. Folks, men's wrestling is the only team in action this week. A late add to their schedule. They are going to Great Falls, Montana to participate in the Battle of the Rockies. That is on Friday the 1st. And don't forget, on the 8th of December, the Menlo College Women's Wrestling Blue and White Duels are happening inside Haynes Prim Pavilion. So go ahead and check out our website, menloathletics.com, for more information on that. And if you can come on out, we'd love to have you out there. We invite you to tune into next week's show when Iman Kazem will select the next wrestler to be interviewed by me, Brian Brownfield, right here on Unrooted Wrestling Edition. Until then, we'll see you next week. Take care, everybody. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize